Hey everybody, welcome back to the Bourbon Note. I'm Greg.
I'm Ben.
And today, we don't want this to go awry, so we're drinking a rye. All right, Ben.
Bring it on in.
We've got
Sagamore Spirit Double Oak Rye. All right, we've got a new bottle here that we've never had before.
In truth, you mentioned it the other day, but I have no idea what this is. I don't know who it is from or anything.
It's a brand, I believe they're out of Maryland, and I probably should have looked that up before we started this, but yep, Baltimore, Maryland. And so Sagamore Spirits is a rye brand. I don't think they do anything but rye from what I've seen.
Okay.
I've had their regular rye, it's good, but I got that when I was not particularly familiar with rye whiskeys.
Sure.
This one is kind of, there are expectations here, and I know you never want to go into anything with too high of expectations, but I've heard a lot of great things about this
kind
bottle.
Of what the word expectations means.
Right, exactly. But sometimes that gets you into trouble, you know,
yeah.
When you have
absolutely.
Your hopes are a little too high. So I purchased this because I've heard so many good things from reputable bourbon channels.
Okay, well, let's start with the specs. This is a rye, so we're assuming like a 95.5 kind of...
I'm not sure if it's that high or not.
Okay.
It is, where's the proof on this? 96.6 proof.
Ooh, they just missed.
And I don't know if this is their own or if it's an MGP. It says, after aging our straight rye whiskey for 4 to 5 years in high char new American barrels, our distillers transfer... the aged whiskey to another barrel, yada, 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 for 18 months. Okay. You guys don't want to sit and watch me read.
So 4 to 5 years and then another year and a half in a second barrel.
Yep.
So
let's get into it here.
Okay.
Very rich. The color on this thing.
It does look like almost like coffee.
Yeah, it's extremely dark.
Yeah.
Much darker than the coffee I drink because I fill mine with... I do the exact opposite with coffee that I do with whiskey. I just pour all kinds of stuff in it.
So I'm all over the place with coffee. Like, you can do the weird stuff in coffee, but I tend to mostly do dark roast, black.
Sure. Interesting. This does have a strong rye note to it.
That's what I'm not getting. It's rye and bourbon are similar to each other, but some ryes are very bourbon-y.
Yep.
This one feels like it's going to be just a rye.
A high content.
Yeah.
High rye content.
High rye. Yep. So I'm looking for the, I'm expecting black licorice kind of.
Very floral. Almost perfumey in a weird way.
It does have a brightness to it.
Yeah, which is interesting because you look at the color on this thing and you're just thinking dark chocolates and dark, you know, maybe baking spices. Let's get into the taste here and see what happens. Cheers.
Got a hint of an aroma. Let's see if it's on the nose or on the tongue.
Wow. That's interesting.
So what I find interesting is typically there, you know, you have a particular like set of flavors that you think when you smell it, and then the taste is quite a bit different.
Yeah,
this tastes like it smells.
It does in a lot of ways. Yeah, it has all the things that are on the nose, but it's got some more stuff.
Oh yeah, sure, definitely, of course.
I'm almost getting a weird sort of like a cedar vibe from this.
Yeah,
are you getting that?
I'm getting it's,
which I've had on other ryes.
It's a weird, like, wood tannin kind of thing, because it's dry. It's astringent a little bit. But there are some wood sugars in there, too. It's not too dry. It does have a... Boy, you could convince me this is 105 proof, though. Like,
it drinks a little warm, doesn't it?
Well, yeah. Warm, and also, like, just the way the alcohol kind of, like, interacts with your tongue. Like, it's a surprise that the proof is actually kind of low for the way it just feels.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's interesting. I'm not getting any of the I'm not getting a ton of sweetness on the palate. Mm-mm. I'm mostly getting those kind of floral, light clove, rye spice. Definitely the oak is coming through.
But not vanilla. I'm not getting vanilla.
You know, you and I tend to be on the same page where, like, bourbon, the dominant note is usually caramel.
Sure.
That's kind of the the forward. For the sweetness on a rye, for you and me, it tends to be the vanilla that kind of shows up. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, I'm not having that quite as much on here.
So I am getting a sweetness, but it's like rye sweetness, not the wood sugar type sweetness.
Really?
Yeah. So there's some sweetness, but it's not crazy sweet. Mm-hmm. The finish is weird because it, in some ways, it lasts like there's a good proof and good flavors that like keep going. Mm-hmm. But it's, I don't know, like it also dies off quick. It's like an interesting experience.
It leaves a lingering taste in your mouth,
yeah.
But the actual finish, like it's very thick and then it maybe thins out.
Exactly.
But then lingers.
Yeah.
I feel like this is really definitely like a rye drinker's whiskey.
Yes, I would agree.
If you don't like rye, you're not going to like this, regardless of the double oak thing and whatever.
Yep.
I think you have to like rye to like this one, and it is a rye, but you know, there are some that we've had that we've, you know, kind of called the barely legal ryes that are 51%.
What we mean is it has to be at least 51% rye, but there's still a lot of corn.
Yeah,
and it's so
still kind of leans.
Very similar to bourbon, just not legally. This seems to be a 95% rye. They put a little bit of malted barley in just for the enzymes, I think.
You know, now I'm kind of getting the rye note on the nose.
Yeah.
It's kind of coming out as like a rye muffin, like a buttered rye muffin.
Which I've never had, but yeah, I can totally see that.
There's plenty of tasting notes I get off whiskey that I've never really, like, I don't eat raisins, but I know what they smell like, you know. But yeah, it's interesting.
It's like brown sugar without the sweetness. Or a little of the sweetness. Some of the sweetness. 37% of the sweetness.
Yeah. It's different than I was expecting.
Definitely.
For sure.
Like what?
It's much more floral and more in those like rye clove notes and a slight licorice note than I was expecting it to be.
I almost feel like it's like a wine finish without the, like, I don't know. There's some sort of like the second barrel definitely has an influence, but because it's not like a wine barrel finish, like it's not missing something. It's just, I don't know. It's a unique experience.
Yeah. Yeah, for sure.
Definitely try some other rye, if you're like new into bourbon, try some rye, because this is a bit of a step away from actual bourbon, I think.
Oh yeah, yeah, for sure. I think this would fall into the category of, I think like this is kind of an aggressive one.
I would think so.
It drinks a little hotter than the proof would suggest, which I happen to like. Mm-hmm. I think you like that as well. Mm-hmm. But it does have those good aggressive rye spice notes, and if you're looking for that, then it's great.
Yeah.
It does that really well. But again, like I said before, if you're not a rye whiskey fan, I don't think this is going to be one of those ryes you can kind of sneak in and drink because it leans towards bourbon a little bit. It definitely does not do that.
Yep.
And a great bottle. I love Sagamore Spirits bottles. And like, how cool is that?
It looks awesome.
I did hear that Alyssa told me this up at Spirits, that... These can be fragile if you hit them just right on the corners of the glass.
I wonder how she found that out.
Yeah, she's got a sample bottle at the store, so a secondary bottle had. So yeah, just be aware of that. But yeah, I mean, this is really good. I don't know if maybe I'm loving it as much as everybody else did, but I'm not going to have a hard time drinking this bottle.
We only recently, a couple months ago, did like a real, like a flight, and we did a rye week where we did several reviews of rye, so we're not the most rye-friendly channel because we just don't know it as well.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
But this one is a little aggressive. Like, there's nothing off-putting about it. It's just, I happen to be a bourbon guy.
Yep. But again, I'm not going to have a problem.
Yeah.
You know, what
are these
my way
run, and are they kind of available, totally available?
So I think that they're they're for the most part available, but not every place around here sells this brand.
Yep.
And it's not because of rarity. I think it's just because some places just don't sell certain brands. Some places do.
Yeah.
This one, I think, kind of is off and on. Like, there's releases of it or something like that, and it shows up here and there from what I understand.
Yep.
So it's available. It's not allocated or anything like that. It's just going to come down to whether or not your store happens to choose to carry it.
Okay.
So, all right. Well, this has been Sagamore Spirits Double Oak Rye on the Bourbon Note. I'm Ben.
I'm Greg. Till next time. See you next time.